how to use templates in DaVinci Resolve. This is going to be a game changer for you. When you master this technique and learn how to set these up first, the time spent editing is going to be cut in half, if not more. So let's get started. So by the end of this video, you're going to know how to build a template, how to use a template, how to adjust a template, and have more time to make more videos. Let's get started. So what are templates in DaVinci Resolve? Frankly, you can, the term template is pretty universal. I'm just specifying DaVinci Resolve. You can use this for your audio podcast. You can use this for your video editing. As long as you've got the same theme going, it's gonna work out beautifully for you. What I would do for, say, making my YouTube videos, I would have a template that would have my little intro video. Do you remember that? That green and yellow thing that swirled near the beginning, that would be in place, all ready to go. I know my audio is going to be on this track, so I'm going to put some audio adjusters there, like EQ and compression. I'm going to put them already on the audio track. I know the video is going to go on this track, so maybe I'll throw in a color adjustment on that track, or whatever settings I want to go ahead and use right off the bat, I can just add those. And then anything like lower thirds, you see the little graphics and stuff that are going down at the bottom of the screen? I can have some of those pre-positioned, ready to go, back up. You drop the new video into place, and then you update the text to appropriate to what the video is now showing. Adjust a little bit front and back, make sure the timing is just right. Go ahead and cut your flubs. It's always, you can always cut your mistakes, and voila, you have the whole episode done. Because every episode's gonna start the same way, and it's gonna end the same way. Your voice is hopefully not gonna change too much, so your adjustments are gonna be very minor when it comes to EQing and compression and whatever you wanna do for your voice, but all that stuff is done. And you can go out there and mix down the video and you're done. So let's see what that looks like. So you wanna build a template for your DaVinci Resolve videos. Well, here are a couple elements. Let's first tell you what a template is, and then I'm gonna show you what I've set up here. A template is some elements that you're going to use over and over and over again for different scenarios. For example, this is a podcast that I work on from time to time, but I've got all the same elements. You'll notice I have the intro and the outro. I'm always going to be using that same intro and outro for every single episode. I've also got the logo at the beginning and the end that is going to be over that intro and outro. This is the email and website lower third that I've got there. And then all I need to do is drop in the video and the audio. I've reserved tracks 1 and 2 to be for the host and for the guest. So when I drop in the video, the host will be on 1 and audio 1, and the guest will be on video 2 and audio 2. So everything is spaced out where I want it and how I want it, and I can use them whenever I want. And one other element that you're gonna wanna put in here. So here is the here's the lower third for the guest. I'll put the website or maybe an email address and the guest name. And then of course for the host, we have the same thing, host website and the host name. And of course those I will change. And then I can simply copy and paste these throughout the entire episode wherever I need them. So there's a copy, and there's a copy, and there's a copy. And I'll just scatter these throughout the entire podcast episode. Something else you might want to throw in there, you have, let me zoom in a little bit so you can see this a little bit better. The good old-fashioned subscribe. Now, what I want to do is I'm going to make this a little bit smaller, and I'm going to put it down. I'm going to put it down a little lower. So size and position, I'm going to make it a little smaller. And then the X and Y. I can bring it over to there and then bring it down to the bottom. And then when we actually play it, of course, we've got the interview going on and that pops up and goes away. Now that's preset here in the video and I can scatter it throughout
as much as I want as well. Two or three times should be enough. And then at the closing, we have the website information. Actually, I'm going to take this one, and I'm going to shrink it down just a little bit. And I'm going to move it to the top so we can see that email and website. And I still have a little room left over for my subtitles when I generate the subtitles later. So this is the basic structure of a podcast, this particular podcast template. Now, you can do a whole bunch of stuff any way you want, however way you want to use it. Maybe you've got other clients that have certain elements the same. You've got other projects. Maybe you're doing a short form video or a long form video or one for YouTube or one for Instagram. You can do all kinds of different things. Setting up templates and being able to use them very quickly. And like I said, you drop in your new video, make a couple quick adjustments, and you're off to the races. This is the video side. In just a moment, I want to go over the audio side with you as well.
Now, I'm kind of blowing through this pretty quickly. Is there something you missed that you want me to do a deep dive on? Anything about the EQ or the compression or something like that? Any type of video editing that you need to see more of? Just drop a comment down below. In the meantime, be sure to like and subscribe because eventually they are coming out. I've probably got them on the calendar already. It's just a matter of making them and you don't want to miss them. So click like, click subscribe. Thanks.
So we just got done with the video side of it. Let's take a look at the audio side of it because yes, you can also do a template for the audio side. So let's switch over to the Fairlight page. And now here we are. We know audio one and audio two are going to be the host and the guest. So what we can do right off the bat is come over here, and I do like the voice isolation. So I'm going to turn that on, and I'm going to do the dialogue leveler. Same thing for section two. Now, for effects, I happen to like this particular EQ, and I'm going to add it. I can turn on band one, and it's going to be my high pass filter. Let's see, frequency. I'm going to move over to here just for the heck of it. And I'm going to, and then I also know for six, that's going to be, whoops, that's going to be a little too harsh. Let's bring that up quite a bit. Somewhere around 6K is what's going to have to happen here. And somewhere in here, we're going to boost that mid-range right around 250 or so. We're going to lower that. This is going to be an average EQ for certain vocals. And I'm going to go ahead and just save that one there. I'm going to do the same thing here. Again, this one is the roll-off. This one is the roll-off. This one I'm going to bring up to about 6 or 8K. The three, I'm going to boost the mids. This is the upper lower. That's going to be about it. Let's bring this right to about there. That's okay for that one. And then I'm going to go ahead and set my dynamics. This is basically, we can set the expander and the EQ, the compressor. Let's bring these down. The ratio, I'm going to bring it to about 2.5. Again, 2.5 to 1. Those are good numbers for vocals. And there you go. I'm going to have to mess with this, but at least I don't have to start from scratch. And then I'll do the same thing for this side as well. Bring it up. 2.5. Turn on the compressor. 2.5. And that one is set. And then if I want to, I can also set my mastering. And this is a plugin that I happen to like. All purpose. I'm going to bring this down to total balance. This kind of takes care of everything all by itself. And there we go. That's your audio. Now, what you can do is just to make absolutely sure. Now, some of those things I did from memory and some of those things I did from experience, especially the compressor, especially the EQ. Now, stuff like this, what's beautiful about this is, let's say this EQ, you've got a whole bunch of presets. And if I wanted to, let's see, where is it? Here's a vocal EQ. Here's a vocal EQ. I would just pick one and listen back to the audio. If I like it, boom, that's my EQ. No adjustments needed. It's very simple to just step through and find out the one you like. What's the one that works really nice for your voice, that works really nice for the piece that you're working with, and not have to make any adjustments. If it sounds good, keep it. It's that simple to start with presets and templates in DaVinci Resolve. And this is how you would set up the audio side of it all. All this is ready to go. You hit save. Do a save as, and remember to save it as with read only in the title. Because when you call it up, you don't want to accidentally call up the actual file and end up changing your template as you're building your new episode. So you would save this in read only mode, and that is your visual cue that when you open it, to open it in read only mode, and then immediately save it with your new episode title. Hope that helps, and I hope it saves you a lot of time.
Now, if you're really serious and you really want to crank out a YouTube channel for your business that will bring in customers and clients on a fairly steady and consistent basis, I strongly recommend you pick up this book. Nate Woodbury, a friend of mine, wrote this, A Hero's Guide to Influence on YouTube. This takes you from beginning to end, start to finish, top to bottom, side to side, covers everything you're going to need to get your videos shot, produced, lit, edited, mixed down, and put up on YouTube, and shows you a few things, some gear you might want to pick up, or whatever the case may be, anything that you could think of in, that goes into producing your YouTube videos for your business can be found in this book right here, and he takes you step by step, by the hand, through the whole thing. Get you a copy. I've got several I can give you. Just pay shipping and printing, and everything is included. You will skyrocket your success. You'll leap to the head of the class with this book. A Hero's Guide to Influence on YouTube by Nate Woodbury. Click in the description down below where it says the YouTube book. Click on it and get your copy today. I'm Nic Natarella with AdWise Creative. Thank you for watching.